International Dark Sky Week is coming up, and this happens every April during the new moon. Hey friends, I am Matt Suess, a night sky, wildlife, and landscape photographer and educator, and also an OMSYSTEM ambassador. I am here to provide you with some valuable tips to help you get the most out of your OMSYSTEM camera gear so you can get some great photographs of the night sky. Now, to get the best possible photos of the night sky, you're going to want to be in an area where there is little to no light pollution. There's a bunch of resources on the web and also apps for your phone, but two websites worth checking out that are recommended by darksky.org are the Cooperative Institute for Research in Environmental Sciences and also the NASA Blue Marble Navigator. Let's now move on to the camera gear you need to bring with you. Now, some of my favorite OMSYSTEM camera gear to use for photographing the night sky, they are the EM1 Mark III, the OM5, the OM1, and the OM1 Mark II. And the reason why is because all of those cameras have Starry Sky AF, which autofocuses on the stars for you. As for lenses when photographing the night sky, especially during a new moon, you're going to want as fast of a wide-angle lens as possible. Now, you can use an f4 lens. You're just going to have to bump up that ISO and deal with a little bit of extra noise. Ideally, you're going to want to use an f2.8 lens or faster. Now, my favorite OMSYSTEM lenses to use when photographing the night sky are the 8mm f1.8 Pro lens, the 7-14 f2.8 Pro lens, the 12-40 f2.8 Pro 2 lens, the 12mm f2.0 lens, and also the 17mm f1.2 Pro lens. An accessory you'll want to consider getting is the OMSYSTEM RMWR1 wireless remote control. This will work wirelessly with the OM1 cameras, and it also comes with a wire to work with other cameras as well. If you don't have that, be sure to set your shutter to a 2-second delay so you don't introduce any camera shake. You'll also want a steady tripod, and that can be anything from this little setup here from Platypod, great for photographing from low angles, all the way up to a normal 3-legged tripod. Just make sure you have a really nice and sturdy one for those long exposures. Now, focusing on the stars has never been easier with Starry Sky AF. Just go into your menu settings in the autofocus section and go under Starry Sky AF. I prefer to have it set for accuracy. I'll also use the middle or the large focusing area, and I'll move that onto a section where there's a bunch of stars. Then go ahead and hit the autofocus button, and the camera will autofocus on the stars for you. Now, as far as photographing the Milky Way is concerned, there actually is a Milky Way season, and that runs roughly from February through October. Really depends on where you live in the world and what latitude especially as well. You'll also want to be out when it is pure dark. And that usually occurs on average about 2 hours after sunset through the night till about 2 hours before sunrise. Now let's move on to the camera settings. Shoot in RAW for the best results. Also, set your custom white balance to about 4200 Kelvin. And make sure your camera is in the M manual mode. As for aperture, shoot as wide open as possible. Now, if my lens is faster than f2.8, often I'll set my aperture a third or two-thirds of a stop away from that widest setting, and that helps with the quality of the stars, especially in the corners of the frames. Set your shutter speed to be open for as long as possible without getting any star trails. Now, this will vary depending on your lens. The wider the lens, the longer you can keep your shutter open. Your ISO is, of course, going to be dependent on your f-stop and shutter speed settings. Generally, you'll be shooting anywhere from around 3200 to 6400 for these dark sky nights. Unlike daytime photos, your histogram is going to be weighted all the way to the left third of the histogram, not going all the way to the right like it is with those daylight photos. Here are some of my photos with the lenses used and the camera settings to get you a head start. Now, let's talk about live composite and star trails. On the newest cameras, all you need to do is set your camera into B mode and then set it to live comp. A good starting point is to set your ISO to 1600, your f-stop at f4, and then also set live comp up for 60-second intervals. Watch the back of your screen, watch those star trails get longer and longer, and stop it when you've got the desired effect. If you want those circular star trails like you've seen in some of my photos, be sure to point your camera to the North Star called Polaris. Here's a couple live comp photos that I took with my camera settings. I hope this video has been helpful for you in getting set up to photograph the night sky. Be sure to experiment with all those camera settings. Go out and have a lot of fun. It's amazing all the shots you can come up with of the night sky, especially when using all the fantastic features of your OMSYSTEM camera gear.